Welcome to Pray With Me, a daily prayer time with Father Alphonse. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us pray for the people who are preparing to receive sacraments of confirmation, of baptism, of First Holy Communion, the confirmation candidate kids and First Holy Communion kids, and the RCIA candidates and catechumens. Psalm 77. I cry aloud to God, I cry to God to hear me. On the day of my distress, I seek the Lord. By night, my hands are stretched out unceasingly. I refuse to be consoled. When I think of God, I groan. As I meditate, my spirit grows faint. You have kept me from closing my eyes in sleep. I am troubled and cannot speak. I consider the days of old. The years long past, I remember. At night, I ponder in my heart, and as I meditate, my spirit probes. Will the Lord reject us forever? Never again show favor? Has God's mercy ceased forever? The promise to go unfulfilled for future ages? Has God forgotten how to show mercy? In anger, withheld his compassion. I conclude, my sorrow is this. The right hand of the Most High has abandoned us. I will recall the deeds of the Lord. Yes, recall your wonders of old. I will ponder all your works. On your exploits I will meditate. Your way, God, is holy. What God is as great as our God? You are the God who does wonders. Among the peoples you have revealed your might. With your mighty arm you redeemed your people, the children of Jacob and Joseph. The waters saw you, God, the waters saw you and lashed about, even the deeps of the sea trembled. The clouds poured down their rains, the thunderheads rumbled, your arrows flashed back and forth. The thunder of your chariot wheels resounded, your lightning lit up the world, the earth trembled and quaked. Through the sea was your way, your path, through the mighty waters. Though your footsteps were unseen, you led your people like a flock by the hand of Moses and Aaron. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Friends, in this technologically advanced age, it is difficult for us to meditate. Meditation requires silence, a particular time you can spend. Meditation is, you know, when you recall to your mind about God and about yourself and how you are dealing with God, how God is dealing with you. And the people who are very busy with office work, with playing on the gadgets, and you cannot easily go back to sleep. But if you sit before you go to sleep, go to your bed, and breathe in and breathe out, and think of God, and try to say a small prayer, whisper a small prayer. Perhaps you can say, "Into your hands I commend my spirit," or "Thank you for this good day, O Lord, and give me good sleep, and that I might wake up in the morning to praise you again." This kind of a small and tranquility, peacefulness will help us to sleep well. See, this psalmist is praying, "At night I ponder in my heart. As I meditate, my spirit probes." And unless we are silenced, we cannot communicate with the one in silence, the God who sees us in silence. And so I recommend, I suggest that we come to see the need for a meditation, even if it is a brief time. Another beautiful opportunity to meditate is before the Blessed Sacrament, going to the church and sit in front of the Lord exposed or tabernacle in adoration, just meditate on the Word of God. Let us pray. Lord God, we give you thanks and praise for this wonderful time, wonderful life that you have given us. May we be able to always communicate with you, be in contact with you through our prayers and meditation. Help us how to know you more and more so we can praise you even better. In the precious name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thank you for joining me in this prayer. If you are blessed by this time of prayer, please click on the like, share, or subscribe button and share with others. May God bless you. It's all you